Howdy, 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 my beautiful Sagittarius. How are you doing today, darling? Let's get into your weekly tarot reading, Sagittarius, for October. See what's going to be happening in your life today, what your horoscope is looking like. And if you do enjoy this tarot reading here, Sagittarius, check out the top right-hand corner of your screen and you'll see a link to your monthly tarot reading. And I'm sure you'll enjoy that as well. Let me know in the comments below how it does help you out, though, because it's nice to talk to humans once in a while. All right? And when you are taking in your tarot readings today, Sagittarius, whether it's on YouTube or wherever, darling, all right, be sure to check out your moon and your rising, not just your one zodiac sign. All right, that's how you get a better understanding of what's happening in your life in specific. And darling, if you do enjoy this tarot reading, Sagittarius, it does help me out quite a bit if you were to give this video a like and subscribe. All right, I always appreciate those who take the extra step to do that, because I know y'all don't have to do that if you don't want to. So let's just begin your tarot reading here, Sagittarius. All right, starting out with what it is you're currently dealing with here. All right, so you have the Seven of Swords, the Temperance, and the Fool energy coming in here. All right, so what it is you're currently dealing with here, this reads off to me, Sagittarius, where it's like you were playing like the waiting game a little bit here, right? You were playing the waiting game for like a being able to start fresh here. You know what this gives me an energy of? It's like you're waiting for a moment where there wasn't nearly as much resistance before you continue going forward here. So let's expound on this just a little bit more. I want to know more about the Seven of Swords, Four of Wands coming in here, and then the Page of Swords. This is interesting to me, Sagittarius. It feels like to me there's some type of situation in your life, especially socially. I could see this as it's like you were seeing someone where it's just like you look at them. You know what this does, Sagittarius? This makes me think of like me being a Southerner. It's just like, you know those people you look at and you're just like, oh, bless your heart, darling. All right. That's how I see this energy as. It's like you're looking at someone and you're just like, oh, bless your heart. You got so much more to work on. You got so much to do. You know, it's like you see where someone needs to just like mature ultimately here. And so because like Page of Swords energy, that's that unrefined communication here. It feels like to me, Sagittarius, that sense of where it's just like you're not fighting somebody anymore. It's just like you want someone in your life. You want someone to be part of your life and to progress with you. You want to have that long-term future with them, platonic, romantic, what have you. I mean, even get majorly like family, right? It's just like you love them, but you got to be able to separate yourself from them, because right now it's just like it ain't feeling too fresh and funky here. All right, I feel like you're being a little bit too patient with them, and I feel like it's time for you to detach from them for a little bit here. You have this Fool energy, so this does let me know at some point in time when they're ready to talk, when they're ready to actually be an adult in the situation, then you guys are going to be able to start fresh and fine again. But I feel like it's really important for you, Sagittarius, to kind of just put your distance with them at this time, because it's just not worth, it's not worth the trouble. All right, even taking this outside of socially, this could be easily a situation of like a trying to get a project off the ground, Sagittarius, and with all the resistances, you're just like, you know what, bless the situation, honey, this just is not the right time for me, right? This just isn't the good time for me to try to get that Etsy store off the ground, because I got so much else going on in my life. All right, don't feel bad about putting a pin on a situation, Sagittarius, because you can pick back up on it. So don't feel like you're giving up, don't feel like you're quitting or anything like that. Spirit's really saying in this sense right now, it's just like, all right, Sagittarius, let's just put a pin on this, let's move on from this, let's keep having life going forward, because at a later point in time things will like figure themselves out for you. All right, and so don't feel guilty about having to walk away. All right, don't feel guilty about it. You do not feel obligated to see something through until the end immediately. So let's see what's manifesting for you. All right, you have the Queen of Pentacles, the World card coming in here with the Knight of Swords. All right, back of the deck energy is the Two of Swords. So what's manifesting for you is just like after you kind of come to terms with the situation here, Sagittarius, where you're just like, all right, we're going to put a pin on this situation and we're going to go into this new path, right? With that Two of Swords, so choosing to go into a different path here. You have the Queen of Pentacles confirming to you that it's like much better for you personally. It may not be good for anyone else involved, because you're no longer, you're cutting off the access to you, right? No longer people are going to be able to quite easily as reach you, but this is the best choice for you. Whatever it is where you're having to detach yourself, Queen of Pentacles, I feel like things are going to finally start picking up for you in a positive way. All right, you have the Knight of Swords coming in here, fast forward progression. I also do want to just make a note here, Sagittarius, it doesn't feel like when you walk away from the situation, it feels like you're gonna have to really stick to your guns about it. I feel like you're gonna be really tested about practicing your boundaries with the situation. because it's like this energy of where it's just like feeling rushed to having to pick back up on the situation when it's like not ready yet. All right, so I want to just make that as a side note real quick here. And then you have the World card coming in here, confirming what I was saying beforehand with that Two of Swords here, Sagittarius, all right, where it's just like you're closing out one cycle, right? The World card's the closure, is the final card in the Major Arcana. So it's like you're closing off one cycle, beginning something else new for yourself. And then it's like your life is able to like really start picking up because you're not trying to like bang your head up against a brick wall anymore. You're just like, all right, like the social situation is going to figure itself out. Let me put my focus in on my finances. Let me put a focus in on my career, because I feel like it's really important for you to just see your situation right now, Sagittarius, and be like, all right, like this just isn't worth it right now. All right, so let's get a closer look at this Queen of Pentacles here, because I really do feel like your finances are going to be really going to be picking up here. Knight of Swords once again for you. Be prepared in the work environments here, Sagittarius, to be really busy. Like, you're not going to have much time to be missing the situation, missing this person, or feeling too down about yourself about walking away from this project currently, because you have a lot of things that are going to be happening in the coming days. And that's probably why Sagittarius spirit is kind of sitting there like, all right, Saggy, don't be banging your head against a brick wall with this, because you're about to have so much else going on in your life that you are just going to be way too busy to continue managing this situation there, whatever that is. All right, Seven of Swords coming in here in the reverse, as well as the Wheel of Fortune coming in for you. All right, I do get for you, what is the Seven of Swords about before I talk about it? Queen of Swords. Yeah. Okay. So here's the thing, Sagittarius. It's almost as if spirit needs you to put a strong boundary in your life here, because it's like once you place that boundary with that situation that just hasn't been good for you, Wheel of Fortune comes in here that starts actively turning in your favor here. So it's like I get, especially in regards to like the work environment and stuff like that, things are going to be really picking up for you. All right, how is this Wheel of Fortune going to be blessing you though? One last card before we move on. Ace of Wands. All right, so this is a card of passion here. All right, so for some of you Sagittarians, all right, if we're going to make this a social reading, I do feel as if for some of you, putting a pin on a social situation, you're not going to be having time to miss them, because you're going to have some new strong attraction coming in to keep you busy. All right, but as well for you, I feel like the more that you have time to focus in on your own passions here, it's like things start picking up greatly in regards to that there. I don't really feel like this is anything associated to like 9 to 5. It's like you're using this newfound freedom or this extra time that you have on your hands to work on like some type of side project or something like that, and that picks up quite a bit there. It's kind of interesting. It's like by you finally, like once you finally give up on or put a pin on this, let's not say give up on that situation here, it really does feel like so much else of your life really starts to begin to pick up, right? So let's continue on here. Eight of Swords coming in here, Five of Wands in the reverse with that Five of Swords here. It feels like part of the reason why part of the reason why you haven't been able to progress as quickly as you wanted to in your life is because of all the damage control and all the drama other people have been bringing into your life here. So truly, Sagittarius, I'll just ask you this one question here. Just like, when are you ready to start having things exciting happening in your life again? When you have the answer to that question, darling, you'll know when to finally put a pin on a situation and be like, all right, you need to find the time to block this off for a while and then put your focus in on some new projects. All right, because I really do feel like financially for you, it's going to be really hard for you to really get anything off the ground while you're still having to juggle with everyone else's problems, everyone else's dramas here. You might even be at this current point in time, Sagittarius, kind of being turned off to social relationships currently and kind of wanting to just be a hermit at this time. I actually don't feel like that's necessarily a bad choice for you currently here. Let's take a look at your social life later on. This is Chariot energy, Seven of Pentacles with the King of Wands here, Emperor card in the back of the deck here. Yeah, this really does feel to me, Sagittarius, where it's just like someone needs to just have some time without you, being around them without you having being accessible to them. It's like someone needs some time to mature, and you distancing yourself from them gives them the time to mature and actually realize like what it is that they, what's important in their life again. And then that's when they're gonna come forward to you again and reconnect and build off of where y'all last left off. Does that make sense? And so I really feel like it's important for you right now, Sagittarius, to like practice some solid boundaries, especially in regards to family, friends. This might be a time for you to just tell all your loved ones right now, being like, you know what, I gotta just make this time for me. All right, I gotta make this time for me, because you really do have a lot of moving parts that are about to happen in your own personal life. A lot of positive things, right? I'm being shown a car, and especially with that chariot energy, you might be having opportunities of traveling here in the coming days, all right? Yeah, and you got the snow leopard card. We're getting into your oracle cards now, Sagittarius. The snow leopard, take some time out of your usual life and spend it in solitude. Yeah, right now for you, Sagittarius, girl, right now for you, Sagittarius. kind of separate yourself from people, because right now some big things are in the works for your own personal life, and you're not going to have the time or energy to be doing damage control or entertaining other people's dramas and stuff like that. You need to make it yourself the priority currently. All right, you have the dog spirit coming in for you, number 19 equaling to one in numerology. All right, so look up the number one later on to see what message that has for you this week. But the dog spirit talks about being loyal to what it is that you love, and I kind of feel like that's being loyal to what it is that you love, meaning yourself, Sagittarius. And I don't even want to hear in the comments right now being like, oh Velca, I don't love myself though. Girl, first of all, I ain't gonna even entertain that. But I feel like it's time for you to be loyal to yourself currently rather than to everybody else. Yeah, two of cups coming in here in the reverse. It's time for you to be loyal for yourself and loving yourself, because it feels like whatever the situation is right now, you've given somebody an opportunity to do that for you, and they just are not doing it currently. They're not either ready, they're not mature enough. So you have to be the one to be like, all right, you don't want to love me, that's fine, I'm gonna leave you there, I'm gonna love myself since you don't want to love me. Does that make sense? Sagittarius, I really do feel like it's time for you to, yeah, four swords. This is a time of personal reflection, time of personal healing here. All right, three of swords energy as well. So yeah, this is a time for you, Sagittarius, just to be about yourself, time for you to be selfish. All right, ignore all these other people, practice your block button. Don't make yourself available to people. It's time for you, allow other people to live their life. All right, you do not need to be everyone else's savior. Right now, it's important for you to be your own savior, because you got so much in the works coming for you in the coming days, but spirit doesn't want to give this to you until you have your plate cleared up a little bit. All right, Sagittarius, so I hope this tarot reading helped you out. I love you so much, darling, and hopefully I can connect to you sometime in the near future. Bye, darling.